It's great to see this jammed house for this great artist and band, dear friend of all of ours. Have a nice welcome for Billy Bragg and the Red Screen.
As I wait for Stein to drag me under, you lead me through my sin and wonder. The things I always meant to do, the things I never said to you, the bad dreams that all came true. You woke up my neighborhood.
Kit Wiggy, please. Oh, it's happening.
Right.
So you know we can all play the new ones. So it'll prove that. Yeah. I know, it was. Deeply grooved, wasn't it? Thank you very much. What about the old ones? You didn't want to play them? We'll see.
Exciting as we sleep in the endless noon. Your mind, we just need to get out of bed before noon. Surely, you know when we sat out on the fire escape talking. Surely, what did you say about running? I
stars, ladies and gentlemen. There they go. Melting back into the hills from whence they came. Guess that just leaves me and you, eh? Just like the old days. You folk fans, I know there's a lot of folk fans in tonight, I can hear you. Yes. The whiff of Birkenstocks. Sorry, Birkenstocks, isn't it, rather than Birkenstocks? This is a new phrase that's just actually come to me, Birkenstocks. I had to find out what it meant from an American friend. And now I know what it means, I'm deeply confused. But there you go. Thank you very much, sir. Just flick my jeans up a bit. And well, it's better than walking around the stage doing this, isn't it? Doing one of the tracks the other night, and they were asking me if I invented a sort of like a Billy Bray kind of duck walk. So I was doing this with when the band was. So we won the band on, I can do things other than just stand and play like I normally have to. So I'm doing this. I was saying that I invented a new kind of duck walk, but what happened was the elastic in my underpants. You know how your gusset drops? You know that, girls. Yeah, tighter gussets. That's going to solve a lot of our problems, that wouldn't it? Or non-chafing gussets, anyway. So I was having a bit of a gusset problem. So if you see me doing that tonight, you'll know. Well, I've stopped it. I know it's much better easier to do. I'll buy a frigging belt. I don't know why I don't buy it. So I've got the time. I'll never forget the first night I met her. That September morning was clear and fresh. The way she spoke, laughed at my jokes, and the way she rubbed herself against the edge of my chest. She became a magic mystery to me, and we'd sit together in double streets twice a week. Some days we'd walk the same way home, and it's surprising how quick a little break can clear the streets. We dreamed of her and compared our dreams, but that was all that I tasted. She likes me with her body, you see. And I lied to myself about the chances I wasted. The times were close, far and few between. The darkness, the dances in the school canteen. Did she close her eyes as I did? And we held each other tight. And la 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 la. What do you mean, boys and girls? I never get that last bit, it's the hardest bit taking off. So that smash with applause just turns my head the wrong angle, you know. She danced with me and I still hold that memory soft and sweet. And I stare up at the window as I walk down her street. But I never made the first team, I just made the first team laugh. And she never came to the phone, she was always in the bath. And then it took me a dictionary to find out the meaning of unrequited. While she was giving herself for free at a party to which I was never invited. I never understood my failings then, and I hide my humble hopes now. Thinking back, folks, she never even liked me. But if she could see me now, eh? Now, come on, that's pathetic. That's pathetic, Leanne. That's pathetic. For a grown man, that's pathetic. Now, you probably know, being as you're a kind of folk clubby kind of audience, you know the importance of... there are some things in folk music that are really important. Perhaps most well, up there among them is kind of like the facial hair is important. Warm, cloudy beer. That's very important in England for us. Yeah, yeah, thank you, sir. And also important... Thank you. I don't know what you said, but it was very emphatic, wasn't it? It was very emphatic. I like an emphatic heckle. That doesn't result to rude words. There, sometimes you get emphatic ones that are just too rude. And I don't like to respond to those. So, but that was emphatic, mate, wasn't it? Yeah, it's not bad. But the most important thing for me in folk music is the audience sing-along. Yeah, that was a whoop, though. That wasn't a sing, that was a whoop. So I know it's very difficult to get American audience to sing rather than whoop, but we've had a real problems with this. And, so far we've only had one gig so far where someone didn't shout out the unmentionable word. Begins with F. Really designed to make people like me really annoyed. Can you guess what it is? No, Freebird. It's a disease. It's a disease. It's all you people listening to Dead Guys Radio. It's all you listen to all the time. I include David Crosby. David Crosby, I'm including. This is the 1990s. Wake up! Is everybody in? Whoops, there we go. Back to Dead Guys Radio again. So we're trying to avoid all that by not dying. And, they might play me. I am going a bit grey around the sideburns. I might be able to get on that kind of, like, you know, and kind of radio. I don't know. Anyway, the point I was trying to make was the audience sing along. Because I've now got the band and everything, I'm in danger of losing my folk singers live. Yeah, thank you. Thank you, sir. That's very good. That's a very good heckle, actually. You missed a year, what you said then? Judas. Anyone know what it's a reference to? Judas Priest. Thank you, sir. That's right. He's a Judas Priest band. That's right. That's great. Last night he shouted out Jethro Tull. He's getting better. No! It's a very obscure Bob Dylan heckle. Come on. All you people who are over 30, you're going to have to explain to the youngins all these stupid Bob Dylan references. That's right. We've started to do that now. That's how you ensure that you get early rope. No, mate, we're going to have an over 30s license next time, so no one under 20 in the 20s can get in. We're trying to raise our demographics. Mate, look, listen, just a minute. Don't blame me for your fucking licensing laws. Do me a favour. I'm just passing through. It's you people who are blamed for your licensing laws, not me. Oh, good. Did you hide him in? Well done. Good. Huh? Shh. Don't let anybody find you. There he is, ladies and gentlemen. He's there. See, I just thought you were using camo, sir. I'm sorry. Come and say that to one of our bouncers. Tell. Who cares? Quite. Yeah, so those of you who've never been to folk clubs before might find this a bit of a frightening experience being taught a song, but those of you who grew up listening, your parents forcing you to listen to Pete Seeger records. Yeah. I had a flashing of people being forced to listen to Bob Seeger records, which was good. There's a lot of facial hair in Bob Seeger too, but it's no Birkenstocks. I think that's today's favourite word, Birkenstock. Yeah. Exactly. Thank you very much, sir. Thank you, sir. You should have a speak with that Judas Priest band over there. You're not listening to enough Dead Guys Radio, man. Oh, fuck. I'm just going to... This is turning into a heckle fest. This is just incredible. This is like trying to walk down the street in New York. It's great. Thanks. Hey, asshole! Not me. I'm a foreigner, mate. Sorry, I already gave... It's good fun, though. I don't see a bit. Yeah, you've been down. I need something more original than that.
Blue Monday!
Yeah, I'll take Groovies in the Heart, sir. Thank you very much. I'm going to teach you this damn chorus before you get so rowdy that we have a stage invasion or something. Can you imagine, do you know what Billy Bragg's stage invasion is like? People leap up on the stage and give me books. Fight with with a fight with the geezers, fight with the security men. And get up on the stage and say, this is a book about Marx when he was in Paris. That's cool. And that's really cool. Yeah. Well, here's a track from our group. That's all right. Occasionally someone tries to punch me out, but it's real. Like the most damage people do is with the microphone. When I get up to shake my hand and accidentally nap me with the microphone. I'll take you with this one, look at this. I hope it's not an earthquake or anything. That's a danger. This chorus I'm going to teach you now. You ready for this?
Yes.
Okay, like it's in E major. Can you deal with that? No, E minor is the saddest of all keys. Man. That's E minor. I'm singing in E minor. His son's explained to his dad what that was. He explained the Bob Dylan reference to him. Now his son is explaining the Spinal Tap reference back. I like all this. I like all this. We'll bridge the generation gap, yeah. After that, we'll burn the damn bridge and be done with it. I don't know what we're going to do. Chorus goes like this. Tra-la-la-la, 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 tra-la-la-la. We're making a world safe for capitalism. Just something I want to add, and this is a special coda for American audiences. I want you to sing it with irony. Okay? Irony. Alright? Irony. Yeah. Don't just sing it with gung-ho-ness and sort of, yeah! We are, yeah! Yeah! Just calm down. If you want to know what irony is George Bush saying he'll do everything in his power to help Magic Johnson. Except spend any more money on AIDS research. That's all right, man. Oh, no, sorry, that's hypocrisy. I'm sorry, that's hypocrisy. Damn. A millionaire folk singer. Millionaire protest singer, that's all right, man. Not that you ever see them. Not around here, anyway. So irony, I want the irony to drip. I want it running down your legs. I want you to be ankle deep by the first verse, knee deep by the second verse. By the end, I want you to be positively wading in it. Wading in irony. Marching some of the covert battalions. Here we come, seeking out the rich, trying to keep the communists in order. Order! Just remember when you're looking under your bed, only 2 days swim from the Texas border. How can a country large as ours withstand such a threat? If they won't work for us, they're against us, you can bet. They may be sovereign countries, but you folks don't forget. They all want what we've got, but they don't know it yet. Tra-la-la-la, 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 tra-la-la-la. We're making a world safe for capitalism. You're howling louder than you're singing again, America. I'm sorry. Now, look, basically, these people down the front, I know they're singing because I can hear them as well as see them. But you people over there, you people aren't so well lit. You should have a word with your lighting, man. You're badly lit people there. But you people over there, I can see your lips moving and everything, but as far as I'm concerned, you may as well be Milli Vanilli. Because not that you dance like that or anything, nothing personal, but I can't hear you. And in order to express your solidarity with your Uncle Bill, in order to express your solidarity, don't you laugh up the back either. You're just the same. I need to be able to hear ya. Up, tra la la. You're just grinning. You're not even singing at all. She's like, I'm right in the front row, Billy Bragg. If he comes over here, I can touch his turn-ups. Get with it. Second verse. Here we come with our candy and our guns, and our corporate muscle marches in behind us. Behind us! For freedom's just another word for nothing left to sell. And if you need Grateful Dead CDs, we can get you those as well.
Can a country large as ours be scared of such a threat? If they won't look for a sneer against us, you can bet they may be sovereign countries, but you folks at home forget. They don't want what we've got, but they don't know it yet. Tra-la-la-la, 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 tra-la-la-la.
Distracted by some kind of like the spirit of Joe Strummer just moved through me somewhere. Yeah, somebody thought I was in Big Audrey Dynamite for a second here, so apologies. I'm getting old. I'm sorry. It's the verse. Here we come with that candy. Yeah, thank you. That one. Yeah, that's good heckling. You could have your own spot actually. Isn't it?
1649, St. George's Hill. A ragged band they called the Diggers, kind of show the people's will. Thank you.
one of the rather more smarter stage invaders in Boston did actually ask me, what's the point of singing that song, a song about proto-communism now that we're in the decline of communism, now that's all over. But the message of that song and of the 1640s, as I see it at the moment, is not specifically about the communist struggle, but it does have some bearing on what's happening in the Soviet Union now. In 1645, I think, the English, I'm very proud to say, became the first nation in Europe to chop off the king's head. I was very pleased about that. I'm very proud that we did that. But we found very soon that we were going to have monarchy back because we didn't have so many American tourists coming in to see. It's not the same taking the king's head on a pole down the mall. It's not quite the same as having him riding in a big gold coat, especially after a couple of years. It's all a bit... The headless king wasn't as much of a hit on the coins and the postage stamps. Wasn't it so simple? Just a kind of stump. And it wasn't so good, so they actually brought back his boy. But the monarchy that was restored in the 1660s was never the same as it was before. Before the Civil War, we had the so-called divine right of kings, absolute rule of the monarch. After, we had rule by parliament. It was a merchant class parliament, but rule by parliament, and the king was part of the constitution. And that's evolved over the years so that now we have universal suffrage, everybody over 18 voting, and a constitutional monarchy. That is, parliament is the executive power in the country, and the monarchy is kind of like the kind of tribal sort of totem sort of thing for some reason that brings in lots of tourist money. So that's what it is. So the correlation between that and the Soviet Union is, I think that now that communism has declined in the Soviet Union, capitalism will undoubtedly return to whatever replaces the Soviet Union, but it won't be the same kind of capitalism as you have here in the US or what they had before in Russia. It'll be different in as much as I think it will be a more mixed economy instead of a free market economy. That is, they'll still have free healthcare, free education, and those kind of things that they've always had there since the revolution, because no country that has ever had free medicine, free healthcare, free education has ever voted to go back and privatise, have private healthcare and private education again. And I think in a country like the US, which is now the only developed country in the world that doesn't have some kind of socialised medicine, I think you should wonder why that is that no other country has ever changed back the other way again. I think it's about time that instead of having the democratic constitutional right to buy a gun and shoot your fellow Americans should have the constitutional right to a free doctor at any time of the day, no matter how much money they have in their pocket at the time.
Sometimes I think about Sydney's child and all about the time we were running wild. I've been searching for the dolphin. Sometimes I wonder, do you ever think this world may never change? It is. And all the ways of war change it back again. Sometimes I wonder, do you ever think of me?
Brendan and Dolphins, Carter and piano and vocals, yeah.
Thank you.
Majority vote for it, I may as well. It has to be at least two-thirds. It has to be at least a two-thirds majority. If you want to debate it among yourselves while I blow me nose, you feel free. See, I've got the tour cold at the moment, so bear with me just a sec while I have a quick go. Anyone want any blow? That's an obscure 60s drug reference for you. Obscure 60s drug users. How's the babies, Carl?
The babies are great.
Babies are great. Thank you.
you.
Judas Priest, you think he's over there, the fans. We're desperately trying to resist in England at the moment a punk revival. They're trying to give us a punk revival. Those journalists who were writing for the fanzines in the 1970s are now writing for the colour graphic magazines GQ and Arena and all that stuff, and are giving us their gob-soaked kind of, what? No, sorry, mate, too late. Those gob-smoked kind of ideas that they once said, you know, all that stuff, is now come down at all style magazines and stuff like that, and stylish haircuts. The Clash even had a number one in England last year with Should I Stay or Should I Go? Yeah, I know. Because it had been a jeans advert. Why, Levi's? I want some Levi's. Why, Levi's? Some Levi's on my own. So we're about upset about that. So, as I say, we're actively resisting, because what a new wave revival means, I know new wave in America now means a kind of dated haircut, but new wave revival, what it actually means is, if you think of the things that we got from the new wave, you got the Knack, and we got Billy Idol. So I'd like to think that perhaps we don't need all that to come around again. And after that, you know what happens after a new wave revival? A mod revival. Do you really want another mod revival? And then even worse, a new Romantics revival, yeah. You'll be able to get out all those old Visage records, Spandau Ballet, Toya, The Cure. Oh, sorry, you're still buying The Cure in America, aren't you? I'm sorry, I didn't mean that. I'm sorry. No, I didn't mean that. I'm sorry. I'm really sorry. I don't mean that. Anyway, we're fighting that because in England what we want is a surf revival. Not that we've ever had a surf wave anyway, but now that the weather, the ozone layer and the weather is totally fucked, we keep having these tidal waves and tornadoes in England, which is ideal for surfing. Consequently, we're going to get our surfboards, get out there on the North Sea, which is so polluted with oil and radioactivity that if you fall in, you become a kind of instant goth, you know, your hair's slicked up. So we want a goth surf wave is what we're looking for, a surf goth wave, I'm not quite sure. Help save the surf goth wave. That sounds like a good time for something. So this is our first big surf wave goth thing. Wave surf. Soft surf. Soft goth surf wave. That's it! The soft goth surf wave is the first big hit. Thank you. Good night.
We try to spend our way out of trouble.
So how does that grab you? It's called Sulk.
You just bloody well grow up. You just sulk.
We learned called the guitar swap.
Take your partner.
Dozy do and all that shit. So you must be feeling pretty proud of yourself here in Pennsylvania. What we're getting rid of Thornborough, whatever his name was, Thornborough. Tell you the truth, we're pretty proud of you as well, actually. We're pretty pleased at the result of that in England. It seemed like, particularly for a candidate who, in the American form of things, just looks rather radical. I mean, not looks radical when you look at him, but what he says is quite radical on that. I thought that was a really good one tiny little step forward. Now, if you can kind of, if you can kind of repeat that all over Pennsylvania, that'll be really great. If you can repeat it all over the United States of America, then I won't need to sing this song anymore. Yeah.
side. They're fired in the side on having fun, fun, fun. They're joining the NRA. From the big church to the big river and out to the shining sea. This is the land of opportunity, and there's a Thomas Trial on TV. Outside the girls, listen to the voice of the soldier down in the Korean South. Take a look out because we're leaving the prize of bringing him
studying the charts and using my mind. I've been studying, yeah. Was that dancing? Were you dancing in? Listen, man. We are dancing, but not in a way that you'd recognise. Hey, man, that's cool. We're going to play you a nice dance song now. We figured that the only way to break through Dead Guys Radio was to record a Beatles cover. And, yeah. We figured that's kind of like popularity, sort of like for all generations. You know, everyone kind of lovable, kind of Paul McCartney, Ringo kind of vibe. Everyone's all kind of, and the kind of like St. John Lennon vibe too. So we decided that we're gonna record this and we're going to watch it sail up the charts. No problem. Watch this.
Revolution, well, you know. Well, I'm doing what we can. Gemini's evolution, well, you know. Well, I wanna see the plan. All right.
so at least she could get some enjoyment out of being alone. So I could say she was left up on the shelf. It shooed me against the well, kid, she mumbled to herself.
Requests in a very high register tonight. I'm not taking like, no, that's not high enough, sir. That's loud. above E major. I love this bit of the evening. It's my favourite bit of the evening. This bit in the dark screaming at me.
Hello.
It's kind of like a. No, they're too high. Too high. I'm too low, sir. Good. That's very good. Thank you, sir. Thank you. Didn't I see you on telly the other day doing that aerobics program?
Thank you very much.
Thank you, bro. That's great. That was good. Don't you ruin your voice. I mean, I would love to stay for hours and hours and hours and play all these songs, but I have to tell you. I mean, one of the things, one of the problems I have is. At the moment is misheard lyrics. Have I confided in you about misheard lyrics? Exactly. What? There's people in England, someone came to me and said, what's the name of that song that starts with the money from her accident, she bought herself a mobile phone? Another great one is in 1649 to St George's Hill, a reggae band, they're called the Diggers, came to lay down a skanking vibe for the Puritans.
I said a founding father's got to Boston, Massachusetts. They're actually trying to get to Kingston, Jamaica. They didn't quite know, they lost. They were out there looking for some more Studio One cassettes because their old ones had been accidentally burned when their brethren Puritans banned Christmas. I can't imagine Puritans really liking reggae. They banned Christmas. Can you imagine that? No, I don't think they would quite get into all that. A bit too joyful, wouldn't it, reggae bit? Another one, someone mentioned the short answer. Another one in the short answer is, does she still love me? She still has my donkey. That's what someone heard. Someone heard she still has my donkey. She had to have it because I haven't got a garden, you see. I live in a flat. And you can't keep a donkey in a flat. Not for long, anyway. Get very angry donkeys in flats. I start wanting to see their own channel program, won't do the washing up, stuff like that, sleep late, shit everywhere. Usual kind of lodger, you know. You remember that donkey I had, didn't you?
Very well.
Thanks, Cara. That's her, don't you dare say anything to me. Face. Oh, don't you dare trick us with something, Lord, fuck it, you. Nigel, the other side stands, hasn't quite worked that out yet. He still kind of looks, hello, Bill, how are you? So consequently, he sometimes wanders into my field of vision quite accidentally. And I say rude things about his trousers. Which isn't hard, is it? Anyway, if you brag watchers, I have to confess now that every single word in this song that you think I'm singing, a damn lamb.
Watching the translation, we think all the time that our space sitting on the end of your bed in anticipation of you giving in and us living in sin. The hot day, the smell of his Brian, the sound of a shower. Finding out, it's all about Adam and Eve are finding out, they're finding out.
Martha Morgan. So you can probably hear from the lyrics of that one the influence that the influence that song has had on the work of Prince, and I've not really had much of a chance to recognise back the influence that Prince has had on me, and I have to say that there are times when I look at Prince's videos and think I could do that. That's easy, no problem. But I can't, because I'm stuck in this kind of like standing here as a singer-songwriter, protesting. I'm standing here not really able to express myself in a more physical body language kind of way. I'm sort of like, you know, I'm stuck with the shaky knee and the pulling of the faces and the kind of phallic imagery of the guitar, which really, as far as I'm concerned, it's not enough. It doesn't say enough. It's just woolly waving. Thank you, it does. Madam, please. What does that say about our Nigel with his bass? Nigel appears tonight as the man who dreamt you in on stage with no trousers on. And then suddenly found out. I say how warm it is here. I wish I had my trousers up as well, too. It's done the right thing. You've done the right thing, but you don't wish I had my trousers up, I assure you that. That was close. So I'm going to now, in the course of this song, express my debt to the work of people like Marcel Marceau, MC Hammer, who I refuse, just because he's been sued by McDonald's, I refuse to call him by his new name. It's not the same, is it? Hammer. It's not the same. It sounds like... Not the same. It'll be next year. I don't like it. I'll stick with MC. Thank you, sir. It was a brooch, and it hit me in the gonads. Unfortunately, I borrowed Nigel's pouch tonight, and consequently, I'm okay. Just wondering what he's going to put his tobacco in now.
What is that sound? Drown me, so I lie awake all night, 'cause I can't sleep with something I can't fight. She's got a new spell, that's how I know. She's got a new spell. The laws of gravity are very got a new spell, that's how I know.
It's been tough. In England the last few months, it's been just difficulty upon difficulty. If it's not been continued presence of the Conservatives, although Margaret Thatcher is no longer Prime Minister, the economy running down, our national football team playing like crap. We've also had to endure 16 weeks of Bryan Adams at number one. And then I've got nothing against Bryan Adams, but the mentality of people, I don't know what it could be, why people should go out and buy that record, but I'll admit, while we were on tour in England, while he was still number one, I was trying to whip up a crusade of vigilantes to go in record shops and stop people buying that damn record. And I'll admit, it did sometimes take the sort of angle of a kind of a crusade against Adams personally. I actually had nothing against him, as I say, as a person. But just recently, I've suddenly felt terribly, terribly guilty and want to go out on stage and sing his praises, because I read that Bryan Adams is going to sue David Duke for using "Everything I Do For You" as his campaign song. So I'm deeply impressed by Bryan Adams, and he's right up there alongside the good guys and gals for me. I did have a sudden image of David Duke singing "Everything I Do For You" to a great big picture of Adolf Hitler. I'm sure, I'd like to think anyway, at Billy Bragg gig, that the majority of people here were very pleased and happy at the result of the election down there that Duke was defeated. I'd like to think that the audience that comes to these gigs has also felt some ambivalent feelings about the crook who they put in place of him instead, that there perhaps should be a better choice for people in this country in politics. But before I start going on about him, I just want to say a few words about Duke. Just because David Duke has been beaten, that doesn't mean that that's the end of that particular issue. As far as the politics of this country is concerned. Now, David Duke and his advisers are looking where all the contributions came from, those out-of-state contributions, which I read 45% of the contributions to his campaign were from out-of-state, and they're looking at where those bank accounts are, where those citizens are, and they're thinking, where else can we run overtly racist candidates out there? Where else can we send people out to exploit the fears of ordinary people? I really do think that as greed, for some reason, in the 1980s was suddenly declared good and people were proud to express their greed, as somewhere it was a positive emotion, I fear the same will become of racism in this decade, that racism will somehow, some way, become something to be proud of. Xenophobia, fascism are definitely on the rise in my country, and I fear in this country as well. You only have to look to what's happening in Germany. Just recently, we were there during unification, and that anniversary was marked by a number of neo-Nazi attacks by young skinheads against foreign workers. And the temptation is to say, well, you know, that's bound to happen in Germany because they have a Nazi past. In the same way that it's possible to say, well, that's going to happen down in Louisiana because that's, you know, the old sort of Civil War stuff that always happens down there. But the reality is that there are racists and fascists in all our countries, in all our states, in all our cities, in our towns, in our bars, in our workplaces, in our schools, in our homes. They are everywhere. And they have to be confronted whenever they say their racist ideas or express their fascist views. Because when you don't confront a racist, in some ways your silence makes them think you agree with them. In some ways you are compliant. You have to speak out. Racists, fascists have to see that the majority of people are happy to live in a multicultural society. Would like that society to be better, but are happy to live in a multicultural society and refuse to think of their neighbour as anything else, as an individual, and decide whether they like or don't like that individual on something much more individual than just the colour of their eye, skin, or anything like that. I'm sorry, sir. What was that you said after it, sir? What did that have to do with the song and the wanker? Because, you see, the thing is that Billy Bragg, you see, the talking is the more important stuff, sir. Are you having any... I'm sorry if what I'm saying offends you, sir, but that's one of the reasons I say it, to confront and to offend people. So, and I do... I'm sorry, sir? No, you didn't come to hear me sing songs, sir. You came to hear me not only make points in the songs, but also to have things to say as well. And I think it's very important that instead of just standing here and singing songs like anybody else, that I try very difficultly sometimes to put those songs in a particular context. And I think the issue of racism, both in my country and in this country at the moment, are very, very important issues. As I say, it's something that we really can't ignore, that we should be talking about, because as I say, if you don't talk about it, the fascists think that they have a consensus going for those kind of ideas if they're not opposed. So I feel very strongly that I have to say my bit, and I'm sure people in the audience here, when they're confronted with those fascist images and ideas, feel also they have to say their bit. So I'll just finish off by dedicating this to two types of neo-Nazi. The neo-Nazi like they have on the streets in Germany, who's violent, in your face, literally threatening your life, that kind of neo-Nazi, who's very, very frightening. But also to the more disturbing type of racist and fascist, which is a type like David Duke, who seeks to use the ballot box to gain respectability for their evil, divisive ideas. This song goes out to both those kinds of neo-Nazi. It's called Accident Waiting to Happen.
And get breakfast as well. That's the way I am. Heaven help me. He said we don't like peace campaigners round here, as he nailed another one to the wall. That's what gets me in trouble. Heaven help me. Goodbye, good luck to the rubbish that you've spoken. Goodbye, good luck to the promises you've broken.
And it was true. Let me tell you, it was true that they said if I didn't went out on this tour, people would be shouting Judas and leaving and not finding it to their, you know, the way it should be and stuff like that. And I said, what, if I went out with a band? And they said, no, Bill, if you sung all them songs in tune. So, as you've heard, I've sung some in tune and some slightly off key for you old-timey folks, so... Sir, if you could have heard Riff Raff songs, you wouldn't say that. No, no, no. Where were you in 1977 when we needed you? What did I say about a punk revival? That's the dread thing about a punk revival, is that those Riff Raff songs might get released again. Whoa, then I'll be in trouble with the PC crowd, I tell you. Oh dear. Thank you. But instead, we're going to go on this one. If you're one of those off-tune singers, please, this is your last chance to sing loud and off-key. Go for it.
I've been Camelot for Jack and Jacqueline, but I'm the giant of our highway filling up with gasoline. Fidel Castro's brother spies and rich ladies crying over luxuries, disappointments, so he calls her on his car phone to sympathise with her. But he thinks that he should warn her that the Third World War is live on CNN. Blinded by the lure of the free market system, and he is reminded that Dr. Oppenheimer nearly invented the atom bomb. But who's going to take the blame for BCCI? Can't blame Joe Starling for that one. I hear it's the sound of someone stacking chairs and mopping up spilled beer, and someone asking questions and basking in the light of the 15 fine field seconds of the stage diver. What's it goes in number one? I offer her embarrassment and my usual excuses. Somewhere down the corridor, out to where the man is waiting, I'm looking for the new world order. Anyone seen it yet? The new world order? But it's the same as the old world order. Them and us. Jack the sales and organise. Jack and the sticky wicket. My Springsteen ticket can be active with the activists who are sleeping with the sleepers while you're waiting for the great leap forwards. Our one leap forwards, two leap back, well, politics can be the same, waiting for the great leap forwards. Here comes future and you can't run from it. You've got a guest list, I want to be on it, waiting. If no one out there understands, still cars waiting for the great leap forwards. If still nobody understands, take over television stations, waiting for the great leap forwards. If still nobody understands, pack in your day job and join a rock and roll band, waiting for the great. Leap forwards, don't tread on my bones, what's waiting for the great leap forwards?
very much tonight.
I'll suck hard on those. Maximum strength. Mushrooms. another dead fan here. When Wiggy said to me that I could play some lead guitar in the gig, Wiggy's the musical director of the Red Stars, he said he'd like me to play lead guitar on some songs. I was so chuffed because for a long time he's forbidden me to go beyond these here two dots up the neck there because I'm not really capable of pulling the exact kind of faces needed for that kind of technical high note work. So, nor have I got the right haircut to be a lead guitar player. So, he did give me a video called Guitar Histronics for Beginners, which is a great video. It starts basically with a fundamental kind of Eddie Van Halen in Nine Green. It works its way up to some spandex excess. It's really a wonderful thing, but as I say, you need that kind of long Nelson-type hair, and I don't really... My hair goes a little bit too new wave for that. I looked at this video and realised that so much of guitar playing, particularly all this stuff up the neck here, this stuff, it's all wasted energy. Energy that's much better conserved and used for the purpose with which we were given it, which is masturbation. Not wasted on guitar solos. So I've developed my own kind of guitar solo, kind of a green guitar solo, a user-friendly guitar solo that's ecologically sound. This guitar solo is it's capable of being recycled in any Billy Bragg song, no matter what key it's in, and it's 100% organic. If you leave it out in the open, you won't hear it because it's a guitar solo. And so consequently, I'd like to lay it on you with a rather gentle vibe. Thank you. In this song, you know when I'm playing the guitar solo because I'm not standing here singing. I have developed a few kind of gentle, kind of like non sort of generic guitar poses that I do that are in no way derogatory to anybody apart from myself. And I figure it's myself. I'm allowed to be derogatory about myself. Is that fair?
Yeah.
Thanks, everyone. A vote of confidence from the audience. Take it away, Sir Week.
Yeah.
get a drugs test. Fill this up, would you please, for me right this minute. And if she comes again, I'm sitting on my head. She seems to be that silence. Oh, if she comes again,
over there where I couldn't see the dots on the guitar that wouldn't paint it. So those of you listening to your bootlegs at home tomorrow think, what happened there? I went into the twilight zone for a sec or two.
Oh, my buzzing.
Walk away, Renee.
What will you do when the war is over? Tender comrade, when we lie down our weary guns.
So you give yourself away as an Englishman so easy. Only the English use that word. I come all this way to be called a wanker by one of my own. It makes me wonder. No, I don't turn it pissed off. I didn't come here to play to English people, I came here to play to Americans, so it doesn't bother me.
When we lay down our weary guns, when we return home to our wives and families, look into the eyes of our sons, what will you say of the bond we had? Tender comrade, will you say that we were brave as the shells fell all around us? Oh, that we wept and cried for our mothers and cursed our fathers, forgetting that all men are brothers. Will you say that we were heroes? Oh, that fear of dying among strangers tore our innocence and false shame away. And from that moment on, deep in my heart I knew that I would only give my life for love. Brothers in arms, in each other's arms. It's the only time that I was not afraid. What will you do when the war is over? Tender comrade, when we cast off these khaki clothes and go our separate ways, what will you say of the bond we had? Tender
say my prayers, leave the lights on at the top of the stairs.
the stars up in the sky. The treetops on a window pane, that feeling smothers me again. That is the truth that we all have to die. The top of the stairs is darkness. The top of the stairs is darkness. I close my eyes and when I looked, your name was in the memorial book. What had become of all the things we'd planned? I accepted the commiserations of all your friends, your relations, but there's some things I still don't understand. You were so tall, how could you fall? Lifetime away is all I'm left of everything we've done. Like a pale moon in a sunny sky, death gazes down as I pass by to remind me that I'm but my father's son. I offer up to you this tribute.
I trust you, you know all the words to these songs because you've been listening to WXPN. Is that the truth? I like to support public radio in this country, I think. It's the only thing I can bear to listen to. And I'd like to take this opportunity to thank them for supporting me and particularly for playing this song. If you get home in time tonight, you'll see me playing this. Me and Cara here, we'll be singing this on the David Letterman show. And watch what happens to the band just after I... Is it over already? Oh, there you go. Well, if you had a chance to video it, you'll see what happens to the band as I sing the third line. They all go like... Boing. The whole song goes boing. Except me and Tibbs are still... giving it punk rock. So, it's a few XPN fans.
Shirts, girls in nice shirts, and my passes, beautiful classes. Just because you're guy, won't turn into a wife. If you stick around, sure that we can find some common ground. When I read them, I had an uncle who
Change for me, but a phenomenal costume change for Nigel. We're all making pants for Nigel. So we'd like to finish off with a kind of like a... Well, we have a problem that the Conrade here has already identified. People have said behind your back, audience, that... I've never liked to say this to your face, because I didn't want to upset you, but people have said that Billy Bragg's audience can't dance. And he's got a point. So this gig, we're on a mission. We're on a mission, because I know we've politicised almost all of you. There's a few more still to do, but we now that we've politicised you, we also want to groove you. Are you ready to be grooved? I said, are you ready to be grooved? Let's groove them.
Thank you. in the heart. Cause love. Listen up, come mates.
Yes.
Yonder lay the bongos of my father.
Stop now, stop. I knew you were out there somewhere, Simone. What are you doing right over there?
Hello, Simone!
Listen, while you're at the bar, could you get me a soda pop? Hey, is that Simone? I'm going to take the opportunity to introduce you all to the Rocking Red Stars, ladies and gentlemen, tonight. The mighty Pip Heroes and the lovely, delicious Barry Quimmons. So let's kick off first up for the slaughter with tattooed legs and tattooed hair, playing the bass guitar all the way from Hackney, England, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Nigel Freeman. Hey! Play silence for his solo, thank you. 1, 2, 3, 4. Can I dig it? Can you dig it? Can I dig it? Chili wankers. Mind you, you need a pretty damn big sock for these guys, I tell you, yeah! Have to be at least knee length. Are you, sir, in possession of a solo?
Okay. I have my harmonica with me. I brought my harmonica.
Good. I was hoping you were going to do some kind of solo. Ladies and gentlemen, for the guitar, and it's some guitar player, it's supposed to be yours, obviously. It's Charlie, ladies and gentlemen. It's Charlie. Wait for the count. You've got to wait for the count, man. The count of Monte Cristo.
1, 2, 1, 2, 3.
The role of facial hair in jazz is even more important than the role of facial hair in folk music.
All right.
As I gaze around me, what do I see? Michael Fronty coming up to me. Ladies and gentlemen, what song are we going to do tonight, Michael? A tambo. Okay.
I need the capo.
You need a capo for your tambo, okay. This is a tambo. All right. Let's hear it then. Here we go. Ladies and gentlemen, the high priest
of high praise from the disposable heroes of hip-hop hypocrisy. Ladies and gentlemen, Sir Michael Franti! Sir Michael Franti! Sir Michael Franti, yes! Ladies and gentlemen, recently moved to Malvern in Worcestershire. That's Worcestershire to you Americans. Former West Midlands housewife, daring, dashing mother of two. Ladies and gentlemen, Cara Tivi. Cara Tivi, the diva, the diva. Direct from her network debut on the David Letterman Show. James Brown, Safe Sex Wiggle, what do you reckon? Simone, why are you standing all the way over there? Because you need a fan, that's why, because it's cool! Cool! Ladies and gentlemen, the acclaimed drummer with the disposable heroes of hypocrisy at the Bongos, it's Simone, ladies and gentlemen. It's Simone. He's going to give it to us now. One, two, three, hit it! Sultan of Swing himself. From Boston, Massachusetts, Sir Barry Crimmins. Sir Barry Crimmins.
Go white boy, 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 go white boy. You ready?
One, two, three, four.
You know, Billy, a lot of people ask me, if I don't like this country, why don't I get out of here? I say, because I don't want to be victimized by its foreign policy.
Would you like to see a solo?
How do you do a solo?
Assume the position. Assume the position. Ladies and gentlemen, from Oakland, California, the wonderful Ronno Opportunity Knox.
One, two, three, four.
Breakings before, now there's someone up here who's always been up here with me. Who? Who? Ladies and gentlemen, from Barking Essex, MC of the Rockin' Red Stars, Lounge Lizard Supreme, a legend in his own lifetime, Swiggy! Swiggy! Swiggy. What does he have for us tonight, I wonder? Pretty casual. He's
probably something fierce. Are you ready? Rhythm all night long. The funky drummer! The funky drummer. Give us a grin then. Ladies and gentlemen, from Chigwell and Essex, Mr. Rob Allen. Mr. Rob Allen and the Traps. And unfortunately, I know it's a terrible kind of free bird kind of thing to do, but now he has to do a drum solo. So I'm sorry and I apologise, but that, it's in the demands of equality up here on the stage. So for ladies and gentlemen, the little Rob Allen of Chingford, Essex, Chigwell, Essex, Chigwell, Chigwell, I can't remember, Essex, Opportunity Knocks. Coming down here tonight, ladies and gentlemen, you've been deeply groovy. And we like the political activity that's given Pennsylvania something to be proud about, to continue in its momentum through this state, through this country, and deliver at last. We don't have to have a radical government in the White House, but a caring government in the White House. A government that puts people before the market, a government that expresses the unselfish side of America that we know is here. That's the kind of government we'd like to see across the Atlantic. Hello, across the Atlantic. So, in the hope of that, I thank you very much. We'll see you all again. 1, 2, 3, 4. Of the Mighty Red Stars. My name's Billy Bragg. Thank you very much. We'll see you again. Good night. Thank you very much for your time. We've really enjoyed ourselves. We'll see you again. Good night.